Cancer is one disease that raises numerous questions in the minds of people. Who gets cancer? How does this disease start? Is it genetic? Is it contagious? Is there a vaccine for cancer? Can cancer be cured? What are the different stages of cancer, and do artificial sweeteners cause cancer? These are some of the common questions that come to the minds of people when they hear the word cancer. Hi. I'm Janavi Sharma, and today on the occasion of World Cancer Day, I will help bust all myths about cancer with Dr. Surendra Kumar Dappas, who's a Senior Director in HOD Oncology, BLK Super Specialty Hospital. He will also share with us treatment options and preventive measures that can be adopted to avoid the disease. Welcome, Dr. Dappas, and thank you for joining us today.
Thank you, Janavi, for the introduction.
Yes, it's wonderful having you here with us.
Yeah, we are absolutely with you.
Yeah. So let's go to the first question. Let's first understand what causes cancer.
So before that, I want to tell you what is cancer.
Okay.
Fine?
Yeah.
So cancer is an uncontrolled growth of your normal cells. And when the normal cells are not going in the right direction, normally, there is a process where the cell divide and the cell die.
Yes.
And when this process is not controlled, there is more production and less cells are dying. It forms a tumor. And this is uncontrolled growth of your cells. Cells are not coming from outside. It's your normal cells.
Yeah.
But their growth is regulated, which becomes dysregulated because of some mutations. And it is going uncontrolled, growing, and makes a tumor. And that's... And sometimes it has a capacity to spread. Then we say it's a cancer.
Okay. Okay.
The two terms like tumor and cancer. The tumor is forming a swelling, and cancer means when it has a tendency to spread.
Okay. So what causes cancer?
So what causes cancer? There are multiple factors, and we know very less factor which causes cancer. Like we always blame smoking, alcohol, we blame pesticides, insecticides, radiation exposure, pollution. We name many factors, but these are only known in 10% of patients. 90% of patients are such, we don't know what causes cancer. So if we go into scientific details, it is an imbalance again between the cell dying and the cell growth. And it happens because of mutations in the cells. And what causes mutations? So these are the things which causes mutation, like pollution, infections, smoking, alcohol, all are the factors which leads to mutations. But there are other causes also which lead to mutations. So there are few infections which lead to cancer. Like I talk about hepatitis B and C. When it is long term, leading to liver cirrhosis and then leads to formation of liver cancer. So this is viral cancer basically. Same we have in our nose, we say nasopharynx, is Epstein-Barr virus, which causes cancer. There is one H. pylori bacteria, which is mainly seen in gastric infections. It makes maltoma. It is again a cancer of lymphoid cells. So even infection can cause cancer. But most of the cancers are caused by smoking. Either it is smokeless smoke or it is in the form of tobacco chewing. And then added on alcohol. So these are the major factors.
So does smoking cause mainly lung cancer, or can it cause other types of cancers also?
Smoking causes all cancers, starting from your oral cavity till your prostate cancer. Right? Okay. So smoking is... and thing which have a lot of, cancer-causing agents, which can lead to your mutations, we say DNA adducts, and then your cell growth is again not regulated, and it leads to formation of cancer. Smoking can cause all cancer, oral cancers, oropharyngeal cancers, then your lung cancer, larynx cancer, esophageal cancer, stomach cancer, kidney cancers, bladder cancers, all cancer can be caused by smoke.
Okay, and is alcohol equally dangerous for cancer? I mean, as dangerous as smoking for cancer?
Absolutely no. Alcohol taking in an limited amount does not cause cancer, but when you add alcohol over smoke, yes, they have an additive causes of cancer. When you're only smoking or are you doing only alcohol, the smokers have more chance of getting cancer as compared to alcoholic. But a person taking alcohol along with smoking, which happens in most of the cases, so that causes an super additive effect in causing cancer.
Okay. How does cancer spread through the body and how are cancer cells different from normal cells?
So as I told, cancer cells are not regulated by our genetic system.
Yeah.
Now they have gone out of hands. We always say bigde hue bacche jaise ki bhi wo ek hi family ke the, but now they are thoda bigad gaye hain, matlab hamare control mein nahi hai, and they are doing the things on their own, so they are not controlled by our system. So cancer cells are, again, they are not controlled by our genetic system. They grow and the speed of growing is much faster than your normal cells. They form mass or lump, and then they try to break the, we say one layer, we say basement membrane. Basement membrane is a tough layer in our cells, which is a barrier to migration of a lot of things. So when they grow faster, the basement membrane is break, and then the cancer cells start spreading through your blood vessels or lymphatic system, going to your lungs, liver, lymph nodes, bones, then it starts spreading. So it takes time from forming a lump, then starting metastasis. It takes time from this stage to that stage.
Okay. Can you explain what doctors mean when they talk about cancer development and cancer mutation?
Cancer nutrition.
Mutation.
So cancer mutations, there are so many mutations, and we see a particular gene. In most of the cancers, it's particular genes which are affected and leads to cancer formation. Like in colon cancer or in breast cancer, where we have studied this system, a cancer starts from a pre-cancer stage, then goes into cancer. So we sometimes say from mild dysplasia, then moderate dysplasia, then severe dysplasia, then cancer, then stage 1, stage 2, stage 3, and stage 4. It goes into a regular progression. And every step is regulated by a genetic mutation. So if this genetic mutation is happening, then the chances of developing the cancer is more. That's why in present scenario, a lot of things are coming. Medical treatment is coming based on these genes. What we say, target therapy, sometimes we say immune therapy, there's so many things. So we have studied these genetic mutations mostly in breast cancer, in lung cancer, in colon cancer, and we are studying in sarcomas also. So each cancer has particular genetic mutations leading to cancer formation.
What are the risk factors of cancer? Is this a hereditary disease? Are the risks same for men and women?
So there are few cancers which are hereditary. So we say 10% cancers are hereditary, which go from family to family. Fine, from person to person in a family. And again, in this, the most common is breast and colon cancers. And because of these mutations, if one family member is affected and you find the mutations on genetic analysis, then the chances of getting breast cancer in the same family or to the siblings is around more than 50%. So these genes in breast, we say BRCA1 and BRCA2. So any person affected with breast cancer having this gene positive, then the same patient has tendency to develop breast cancer on opposite side. She can develop ovarian cancer, she can develop uterine cancer, so she can develop any cancer. But again, her sisters or her daughter can get cancer if the gene is present in them also, the mutations is there also.
Mm-hmm.
So breast is one where we have hereditary cancers. Then second is colon cancer. There are two main cancers where family plays a role.
Okay. What about the other types of cancers like prostate cancer or blood cancer?
Like about oral cancer. Oral cancer is not hereditary. This is basically we say it's because of your habit. This is habit for, because of the habit forming cancer basically.
Yeah.
If you are oral tobacco chewer, then you get a chance of getting an oral cancer.
Yeah.
And in India, this is one of the most common cancers. 35% of cancers in male or female are oral cancers.
Mm-hmm.
So, and it is, if you see the state-wise, where the habit of chewing is more, this cancer is more predominant, like in Bihar, in Uttar Pradesh, in Gujarat, part of Delhi, you have a lot of these oral cancers.
Mm-hmm.
So when you go to Haryana or you go to Western UP or you go to the mountainous areas like Uttarakhand, Uttaranchal, then you have a lot of smoking related cancers like throat cancer, laryngeal cancers, voice box cancers, and lung cancers, and sometimes food pipe cancers. So when you go to Kashmir, you have a lot of gastric cancers or esophageal cancers. So colorectal cancer is much more common in Kashmir as compared to other states. So even this is endemicity is there because of their habits. So habits play a role in developing cancer also. But again, in these, there is no family history like this. In oral cancers, if one member of the family is chewing tobacco, other is also chewing tobacco, does not mean it is transmitted from him to her. It is because of the habit.
How is cancer treated and why is it so difficult to cure cancer? Are there any vaccines that can prevent cancer?
So, cancer is a word, I always say, which has a lot of relevance to patients. They know one word, cancer. But in today's scenario, we should know which type of cancer, which organ is affected with cancers. It is spread or it is localized. Like in breast cancer, we talk about breast cancer has multiple types, hormone positive cancer, hormone negative cancer. So each cancer has its own treatment. So broadly, cancer has three treatment options. One is surgery. Another is radiation, and the third one is chemotherapy. Nowadays, we talk about target therapy and immunotherapy also. They're the part of systemic therapy. So broadly, if you ask me, the curable treatment for cancer is surgery or radiation therapy. Systemic treatment like chemotherapy, target therapy, and immunotherapy comes into play for stage 4 cancers mainly, except few cancers like blood cancer, lymphoma, sometimes testicular cancers. Here, chemotherapy is having a curable intent. But otherwise, chemotherapy does not cure cancer. It can prevent the spread of cancer. It can reduce the cancer size. So, and sometimes chemo is helpful for us, for surgeons. We give chemotherapy, reduce the tumor size, then we operate. But broadly, chemotherapy does not cure cancers, except few cancers, what I told you. Now, talk about cancer vaccines. Till today, we are only successful in developing a cancer vaccine for cervical cancers, means gynae cancer, basically, which is cancer. And that is, this is a cancer which is again forming because of chronic infection in the cervix. So the female having multiple partners and can have chronic infection in the cervix, and this chronic infection, if not treated at the right time, can lead to cancer formation in the cervix. And it used to be one of the most common cancer in females, but now with a lot of precautions, education about this, and I can say availability of vaccines since last 10-12 years, the cervical cancer has gone down and breast cancer has become number one cancer in females. So cervical cancer vaccine is available. This cancer vaccine is basically for an infection, which is HPV infection, human papilloma virus. This is virus. So this vaccine is available for viral infection. So when you give this injection, so it can prevent infections. And when infection can be prevented, it can delay your formation towards cancer, and it can make your chances zero to develop cancer. So this cancer vaccine is available. Otherwise, others, we don't have cancer vaccines. So this human papilloma virus can cause cervical cancer, it can cause penile cancer, it can cause throat cancers also. So maybe in future, even males are getting this vaccination nowadays, just they should not get penile cancer and throat cancers. it's not practiced in India, but it's practiced in Australia and other countries where even male get this papilloma virus vaccine.
So are there any new advancements made in the field of cancer treatment?
Advancement is in technology. There are not new treatments basically.
Okay.
So like if you talk about surgery or we talk about radiation therapy or chemotherapy, so we'll go one by one. Like in surgery, we used to be doing a lot of open surgeries. Like we used to cut the abdomen or the chest or the mouth, and then it was too morbid, means with a lot of side effects. Now, around 30 years back, we went into minimal invasive surgery, means you started doing laparoscopic surgery. So that your recovery is fast, blood loss is less, patient can go back home early, and you can start next treatment for cancer as early as possible. So in cancer, I told you, we do surgery, then sometimes we give radiation therapy or chemotherapy. So when you do open surgery, your healing is not good. So your next treatment is delayed. But when you do minimal invasive surgery, then your healing is faster and you can start your next treatment early so that you get a benefit of early treatment and more chances of cure. So in minimal invasive surgery, we have two options, either laparoscopy or nowadays we have robotic surgery. Again, both are similar, but laparoscopic surgery, the surgeon is sitting or standing at the patient's side and operating. In robotic surgery, the surgeon sits away from the patients on a computerized system, which is a surgeon console, and control the robot over the patient and do surgery. So it is one of the most well-controlled, very precise and magnified surgery, having less chances of injury, blood loss, early recovery, early discharge. So these are the advancements going in surgery. So robotic surgery is the new concept in today's present era. This is the future of surgery for all surgeries, I can say that.
Yeah.
Now when you talk about radiation therapy, we have different machines. In the past we used to have cobalt machine. Now we have IMRT, IGRT, we have tomotherapy, we have cyber knife. There are so many things available for radiation therapy, and the purpose is to reduce the side effect of radiation therapy to the patients. Then in chemotherapy was supposed to be poisonous for all of us. Ki poison hai. Then chemotherapy is being replaced by target therapy, immunotherapy in most of the cancers, and target therapy and immunotherapy are less toxic, less poisonous, less side effects. So it's more tolerable and having good effects. But they are costly treatment. We have to afford them. It's not easy for everyone to afford that. So advancement is basically in treatments. There are no new treatment available. Now we are just going into 2021 and cancer is spreading very fast. So we are focusing on genetic therapy. Very soon we say molecular therapies. And maybe in future we can cure the cancers more effectively once the gene therapy and molecular therapy comes into picture. So maybe in future this is the main option for cancer treatment.
Okay. Can you elaborate a bit on the molecular therapy for cancer?
So like it is again like target therapies, like in prostate cancer, we have gallium. This is an ionic agent which can target to the prostate cells and will destroy them. Mm-hmm. But now this treatment is offered after many treatments. Like for prostate, we offer surgery first, then we offer hormone therapy, then we chemotherapy, and then we fail, we always go for molecular therapies.
Okay.
We say theradiagnostics. But I'm saying it is an upcoming field. Maybe in future, we can have more molecular markers for treatment in cancers.
Okay. So are there any similar symptoms across all cancers that people can watch out for?
Yes. So when you talk about similar symptoms of all cancers, there is basically, we will say advanced cancer,
okay,
like weight loss,
mm-hmm,
like we say loss of appetite, khane ka man nahi kar raha. So these are the two symptoms which will always say advanced cancer.
Okay.
So early symptoms means very difficult to detect, but early symptoms are the things which we want to go for. So every symptom have some early symptoms, so that we can detect early cancer in that system. But loss of appetite, weight loss, loss of energy. This is all symptoms of advanced cancer. Most of the advanced cancer people like this.
Okay, once the cancer has progressed.
Spread and very well advanced, then we don't feel to eat.
And these are common and across then, all cancers.
Yeah, and then we have a lot of weight loss. This happens.
Okay, what is the role of diet in cancer? Can you tell us which foods can help us prevent cancer and which foods can actually lead to cancer?
So frankly speaking, we have not studied diet in causing cancer or in treating cancer.
Okay.
So till now, no food particle is directly related to cancers, neither in causing or not healing. But yes, when you are treating your patients, your diet plays a major role.
Mm-hmm.
Why? I always say your immunity is the one thing which is your immune cells are fighting with the cancer cells. And if you're nutritional deprived, then your system will not be fighting with the cancer cells. Whatever treatment you are giving, you are doing surgery, radiation therapy or chemotherapy, they will not be effective if you are not healthy. You cannot tolerate your treatment if you are not healthy. So your diet plays a major role when you are treating your patients who are suffering from cancer. Like if you talk about a patient who has anemia, means less blood. So if you want to operate them, it's very rare recovery for these patients. But sometimes what we do, we start iron therapy to these patients so that the hemoglobin is built up and then these patients' recovery is fast again. So diet plays a role in recovery during treatment, after treatment. But diet does not cause cancer, basically does not cause any cancer.
Can lifestyle trigger the development of cancer? Can you give a few tips to avoid this disease?
Yeah, lifestyle always plays a role in developing cancer. And I will tell you particular one cancer, which is endometrial cancer, means uterus cancer.
Okay.
It is seen mainly in females who are obese, who are diabetic, or who are hypertensive. We say OHD, obesity, hypertension, diabetic. They are the patients who are very prone to get endometrial cancers or uterine cancers. And obesity is again a lifestyle disease. Hypertension is a lifestyle disease and diabetes is a lifestyle disease.
Mm-hmm.
So this is one cancer I can say is a lifestyle disease cancer, but the lifestyle cancer. So we should be very particular about exercise. If you are lethargic, you are not good exercise, you may be diabetic soon, you get a lot of hypertension and bound to get cancers. So we should be very particular about exercise, not only females, but males also.
Is there a relationship between sleep and cancer?
Which cancer?
Sleep. Sleep, stress, stress, anxiety, and cancer.
So again, I don't relate sleep to cancer, but I always say when you are positive, your recovery during your treatment is good, but when you're negative, you are lethargic, you are always loss of sleep. So your recovery will be less and you have a lot of symptoms during your surgery, your chemotherapy or radiation therapy, means mentally you become ill. And when you're mentally ill, you cannot be physically healthy.
Mm-hmm.
But lack of sleep does not lead to cancer.
Okay.
But yes, it can affect your recovery during cancer treatment.
Okay. So there are many myths surrounding cancer. To help separate the myth from the fact, can you give us a quick yes or no for the following questions?
So cancer, I say cancer is the biggest. Cancer is the biggest myth, Janvi.
Okay. Why do you say that?
So cancer is the biggest myth. Yeah, cancer is the biggest myth. So starting from diagnosis till treatment, they're all myths. The first, when you want to diagnose a cancer, patients say, I don't want to go for a biopsy because biopsy will lead to spread of my cancer, which is totally a myth. Without biopsy, you cannot know it is cancer, which type of cancer and what treatment you want to give. So biopsy will give you the answer. But log biopsy karana hi nahi chahte ye kya ki biopsy ke baad chhedne se fail jayega. This is the biggest myth. Then second myth is that कि भी कैंसर ठीक हो ही नहीं सकता, इट इज नॉट क्योरेबल, मरना ही है अगर कैंसर हो गया तो। ट्रीटमेंट लेके क्या फायदा, ट्रीटमेंट से ज्यादा लोग मरते हैं, कैंसर से कम मरते हैं। अगेन अमित, सो वी हैव थाउजेंड ऑफ पेशेंट्स हु आर सर्वाइविंग, दे गॉट बायोप्सी डन, दे गॉट द ट्रीटमेंट डन, बट यस आई वांट टू से दैट ट्रीटमेंट इज नॉट इजी, यू हैव टू बी वेरी पॉजिटिव ड्यूरिंग योर ट्रीटमेंट। So again, people say it is very expensive treatment. Yes, it's not a myth, it's a fact. Why it is expensive? 80% of patients are diagnosed at stage 3 and 4. An effect about cancer is later your diagnosis, more and more less, more and more chances of you will not survive, and more and more you are spending money on that. But early the diagnosis, easy the treatment, either surgery or radiation therapy, less expenses, more chance of cure. So if 80% of patients are diagnosed in stage 3 and 4 and they are getting surgery, radiation and chemotherapy or spending money on all, and then you get the disease back within 2-3 years, and then we always say it is not a curative treatment and the expenses are so high, yes, it will spread like this only. So if we don't detect the cancer at early stage, you cannot know the benefits of the treatment. You always say it is very expensive, yet it is expensive. Why? Because you are coming at a late stage.
Yeah. Okay. Many cancer patients believe that eating sugar will make the cancer worse. Is this a myth or is there some truth in it?
See, sugar has no role in causing cancer. But nowadays, we all, either we are cancer patients or we are not a cancer patient, everybody want to avoid sugar. Why? Because sugar leads to weight gain excessively. So having less sugar will help you during your treatment also. You feel energetic. So sugar should be avoided, but till now we are not able to find a correlation between sugar intake and cancer causing. Okay. It's not like that.
Is cancer contagious?
Never ever. Biggest myth, cancer does not spread from one person to other person. Yeah. So from touching, physical contact, kissing, it does not spread like this. Okay. So it is very commonly we see patient used to come, ki main apne bacche ko inse dur rakhun, mere bacche ko to nahi ho jayega. Absolutely negative thoughts. It's the biggest myth. It never spreads from one person to one person. You can eat in a single tray, you can eat from a single glass, that does not matter.
Does artificial sweeteners cause cancer?
No, it's not like that. It's all again a myth.
Okay. Do cell phones or mobile towers cause cancer?
See, we studied mobile phone uses for brain cancers and we were not able to find any evidence. But yes, we say excessive use of phones can lead to a lot of disturbance in your ears. Mm-hmm. And then you think it can lead to brain cancers. But till now, we don't have a fact. But if you can avoid excessive uses, good for everyone, which is not avoidable nowadays.
Will alternative healing therapies work in the treatment of cancer?
I will say yes. Why? It is not giving you the treatment, but I told you the rehabilitations means post treatment, your recovery, it is having a tremendous benefit in the patients. Like if a patient treated with any cancer, then starting doing yoga therapy or some behavioral therapy, art therapy, is busy, is not thinking about his cancer or her cancer, then your recovery is fast. But when you are treated and you are thinking always about cancer, dubara aa jayega, kya karu, meri life kharab ho gayi hai, mujhe kyun hua, so all these thoughts leads to a negative impact on recovery. But directly these alternative therapies leading to cure of cancer, I will say no.
Okay.
They are not curing the cancers. They're just helping us in recovery of cancer treatment patients.
Cancer treatments are not recommended for pregnant women. Is this true?
It's not like that. If a pregnant female has cancer, it depends on what stage of pregnancy she is. Like early pregnancy. So early pregnancy, if a patient develops cancer and it is a curable cancer, so we need to do surgery. Fine. And surgery in a pregnancy females is easy, but it can lead to abortion of the fetus. So we try to avoid surgery in first trimester. But in second trimester, you can do any surgery. You can do breast surgery, you can do food pipe surgery, you can do any surgery. But again, the risk of abortion will be there. So in thyroid cancers, we do thyroid surgeries, but iodine therapy should not be given to pregnant females because it affects the fetus. So there are different things, but ideally cancer treatment cannot be done in pregnant female is again a myth. It can be done, but again, your doctor should know which treatment is safe to the pregnant female and to the new unborn child, basically, I would say. You have to be safe on that.
Is hair loss after chemotherapy permanent?
Hair loss to chemotherapy is never permanent. Hair loss to chemotherapy is temporary. And I will say the chemotherapy effects, most of the effects are temporary. All side effects will go with time. Hair loss will, if you start chemotherapy today and after 6 months your chemotherapy is over, once your chemotherapy is over, within 6 months you can have your new hairs. So it's not a permanent hair loss.
Okay, Dr. Dabas, thank you for being with us today. Is there anything you would like to add for our viewers?
So I will say 4th Feb is in Cancer Day, and I will not say let's celebrate the Cancer Day. I will say let's celebrate our win over cancer. And how you can win over cancer is you should participate with your doctors in early detection of cancer and early treatment. And to detect the cancer at early stage, you need to check up yourself every year, at least the people who are more than 50 years. And females should go for screening for breast and cervical cancers, which is an easy screening. We should stop smoking from now onwards if you want to be cancer-free in next 10 years. Start exercising every day for at least 30 to 45 minutes. Healthy mind is the best mind, I can say that. So even after doing everything, you can still develop cancer. Does not mean if you are non-alcoholic, non-smoker, doing exercise every day, you are doing yoga every day, it does not mean you cannot get cancers. Still, you need checkups. So please focus on your health, because health is the actual wealth. This is my message to everyone on the Cancer Day.
Thank you, Dr. Dabas, for being with us today and helping us understand cancer better. It was wonderful having you with us. Thank you.
Thank you, Janvi. I'm lucky to be with you today.